I'm Kat, and this is How to Survive AP Research.
Hey, Brian, what's the difference between AP Research and AP Seminar?
Well, Kat, you see, AP Seminar is more synthetic research, wherein you look at sources and you put them together, and that's it. And also, you're restricted by a stimulus packet. AP Research, however, you choose your own topic, and you're allowed to experiment whatever you feel that you need to.
Hey Brian, what's on the AP exam?
Well, the AP seminar exam has a 4,000 word essay, a 15 minute presentation with an oral defense. The paper for the AP seminar exam has an introduction, lit review, abstract, methodology, results, analysis, conclusion, and words cited.
Hey, so how would you pass the exam?
Well, Brian, I'll give you 4 tips to make your life a whole lot easier. The first one would be, don't procrastinate. Also, do not copy and paste. Also, start early to get better results that are more accurate and so you can get a bigger sample size. And finally, don't mess around in class. Don't shop for prom dresses in class. Fake your results. Plagiarize.
So Kat, what are the pros and cons to AP Research?
Well, Brian, you get the freedom to explore any subject / field you want, and you get to work on your own schedule. However, you are prone to procrastination, you have to find mentors, and it's really hard to find enough information that already exists.
I don't know anything.
Join the class, you'll be fine.
Why are you whispering?
Join the class, you'll be fine.
No, they're already in the class. Not judgmental enough. Drop out of the class. No. It's the right thing to do.
No, okay, you know what?
It's
gonna be.
It's not that
if
bad.
If we could do it,
it's
you could
not
do it.
Exactly.
Oh, there we go.
Good stuff. That's it, right?
Okay. Yeah, thanks for watching.